Welcome back. Our next guest tonight was a founder of Paragon Theater and now currently serves as the art and cultural director for the city of North Glen. So please welcome Michael Stricker.
Like he's done a thousand times before. Don't you love him?
So as I said, you are now serving as the arts and cultural director for the city of North Glen.
I am.
What does that mean?
Okay, it means a lot of things. I do a lot of different things every day. It's kind of all under the umbrella of North Glen Arts, which is all of the arts and cultural services that the city of North Glen provides. Yeah. So it mainly happens in the 320-seat theater D.L. Parsons. It's been open since 1975, mm-hmm. which is crazy. It's exactly as old as I am. And we also provide services throughout the community, like with summer concert series,
Very
movie
cool.
series, all that kind of stuff. So,
cool.
so my role in all of that is I supervise this incredibly talented staff that goes out and creates all the programming
exactly.
and all that kind of thing. And we get all these great services out to our community.
Yeah, so. For sure. There's so many different things. Like, so North Glen Youth Theater?
North Glen Youth Theater is kind of, our crown jewel program. Yeah. It's a little over 20 years old. It's run by Kimberly Youngian. As a matter of fact, you've had some experience with her when you were a young man. Right?
many moons ago,
moons ago, North Glen Youth Theater, it's incredible. It's we cast 8 to 18-year-old youth, and they get up and perform a show, and it's not your standard little, junior high kind of show. We hold these youth to a really, really high standard. They rehearse for 9 weeks.
Yeah.
They then perform for 2 weeks. It's an incredible program.
Yeah.
Kimberly does an unbelievable job.
Yeah.
We sometimes these casts are, 50 strong.
Yeah.
And
has won many awards.
Many.
And,
it's won more new National Youth Arts Awards than any other youth company in the state.
That's fantastic.
Yeah. So
That's
it's really an incredible cool. program.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And coming up, North Glen Youth Theater is doing my favorite musical, which I wish I could audition for, Mary Poppins.
Maybe we could change the rules a little bit.
Maybe.
A little older than
just
18.
Like 8 to 18 plus Avery.
Plus Avery. Yeah, yeah exactly.
I'll just be in the ensemble. That's all I want. You know.
Hey, it's a great idea.
Yeah.
I'll talk to Kimberly.
I think we should do it.
Mary Poppins, I mean, it's, the classic story.
Yeah.
It's a really, really fun musical.
Yeah.
We have auditions here in about a month, and already, we've got kids coming out of
And
everywhere.
I just think it's so cool. Like, these are not just, like, Frog and Toad and these are full-blown musicals that these kids are getting to do.
Exactly. We just did Into the Woods.
Into the Woods,
Stephen Sondheim. Full
cast, full
music. It's incredibly
music.
Difficult music and stuff. So we have a lot of fun with it. It's a really unique program.
Yep. And then you had all these 18-year-olds who couldn't do theater anymore, so you started an adult group.
Yeah.
North Glen Players.
Exactly. Yeah. What was nice about it is, there is a lot of community demand for theater, especially for them to be able to participate in theater, because there's a lot of great professional theater that's going on all over the Denver metro area.
Okay.
And so for us, we saw a niche in that we wanted to do mainly musicals, not always, but we wanted to do larger scale productions, but do it as a community based theater.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll bring in some of the best talent that's around, and then we get to combine that with people that maybe haven't acted for 15 years because they've been raising their kids or whatever it is. And so North Glen Players is about 5 years old now, and we just did a funny thing happened on the way to the Forum, which is hilarious.
It was a fantastic
great.
Production.
Yeah. Yeah, and believe it or not, now in December, we're going to be doing a good old-fashioned redneck country Christmas.
Oh, wow.
Really cheesy. And really fun and actually kind of heartwarming.
Okay.
And so that's like our next production.
That's
but Players is it's a blast.
Exactly.
It's a lot of fun.
So let's talk about some other non-theater related stuff.
Okay.
We have the summer concert series you guys are doing. Yeah.
Yeah. We're and actually your guest tonight, Ryan Chris, is in our season, which is awesome. And so we've been doing our summer concert series since like 1988 or something like that. And it's right across the park from the theater. So it's an EB Rains Junior Memorial Park. We do 6 concerts throughout the summer, and it's a really popular program. Got food trucks, all that kind of stuff. We do a summer movie series then on Friday nights in August, which is also really popular. We keep that park hopping.
Hopping.
We got a lot of
very
stuff
busy.
Going out there, especially then with our large scale events that we do as well.
Yeah, and there's so many things. I mean, the sculpture tours, and I mean all this stuff. So how did you get into this role in the first place?
Well, I interviewed and happened to get the job somehow. I don't know. Yeah, no, so I hope what it was I just have this deep passion for getting arts and culture out to citizens.
Yeah.
I want it to be accessible to everybody. And I've actually been in this position almost 10 years now.
Okay.
It's been a great ride. I absolutely am having the time of my life doing all of this because I get to do so many different things.
Yeah.
I have a fairly extensive background in theater and all that kind of stuff, all the way from being an actor to a director, producer, and everything else in between.
Yeah. Including Paragon Theater.
Yeah,
Paragon so that Theater. Was you say many years ago, but not that many years.
It feels like a long time ago, yeah.
So talk about that a little bit.
Yeah, so Paragon Theater, I was a co-founder with Warren Sherrill, and it was great. We started Paragon down in Denver, down here, and it was great. We ran for 12 years. We really took our inspiration from a lot of the ensemble theaters from around the country, particularly Steppenwolf, places like that, where we really tried to break down some of that hierarchy in theater and just get a bunch of great artists in a room to tell a really powerful story. Man, it was fun.
Yeah.
It was great. We did it for 12 years, kind of bounced around into a few different facilities, and got to work on, you know, some of the greatest theater out there, you know, like the late Sam Shepard, who just passed away. We got to do A Lie of the Mind, and it, you know, that show was incredible. So that's kind of what Paragon Theater was built for, we got to do a lot of great stuff with an incredible ensemble.
Perfect. Yeah. Well, thank you so much for coming on tonight. We love talking with you.
Absolutely. Yeah.